you get those suckers?
It took me a couple of days to track the Daltons down.
They can't get away with this!
And in that time, a whole posse of local vigilantes offered to lend a hand.
We'll track them to the ends of the earth.
They seemed as determined as me to find those outlaws. But as we headed into those swamps, it was like I had my own private army. There was no way those boys were getting away this time.
It was early fall, right? Beautiful time of year. At least you had the weather on your side.
Not by my recollection. It was damp and foggy as hell. It was tough to stay on a true course, so we kept an eye out for landmarks. It was autumn. The maple trees were in full color, red as blood. The rains that year were torrential, so the whole area was flooded. The vigilantes had spread out wide, and pretty soon I couldn't see anybody. Except for some sumbitches ahead of me wanting to do me harm. So I had to face them alone. I wondered why my compatriots didn't come running when they heard the shots.
Here.
So did you find the Daltons?
Not yet, but I did have the questionable pleasure of meeting a few of their friends.
Did that asshole just kill Red?
The boys had established quite a reputation by that time, so they attracted all manner of riffraff to their cause.
You think I don't see? They're gonna need a dust pad to pick you up. Kill that cocksucker!
And my reinforcements was nowhere to be seen. Point being, I was under serious attack.
Somebody kill that sumbitch! This sumbitch is loaded! That beat us all!
But luckily, a barn materialized as if right before my eyes. I scrambled up top to get a better view. But just ended up falling inside.
So, how did you get out?
The barn doors was open. About right then, I saw some suspicious characters running through the bushes. Of course, I followed them. But that goddamn swamp was like a goddamn maze, and pretty soon I had no goddamn idea where I was. Steve? So I just started walking, and pretty soon I... Steve? Steve?
No, I'm listening.
Indians surrounded me from all sides.
Indians?
There were Indians?
No. I just wanted to make sure Steve was paying attention. Now, where was I?
You were following the Daltons, through a swamp?
That's right. See, Steve? Dwight's paying attention.
No, I'm listening. I was just resting my eyes.
So, where was I?
The Daltons.
Right. See, there's a reason so many outlaw gangs are made up of brothers. Being a brother is a very sacred thing. It's a bond like no other.
Stop that, son of a bitch!
So did you ever find the damn Daltons?
Not yet, but I did find a few of their cousins. You Kansans breed like rabbits. More Smiths or Heimhoffers or who knows what. But hell, what's more important than family? I bet Ben knows what I'm talking about.
Kill that son of a bitch! That is all!
asshole!
Come out, you yellow bastard!
Somebody kill that sumbitch! Bury him in the swamp! Hunters,
stop that, son of a bitch!
Bounty hunters,
stop that, son of a bitch!
Hunters,
stop that, son of a bitch!
So did you ever find the damn Daltons?
Not yet, but I did find a few of their cousins. You Kansans breed like rabbits. More Smiths or Heimhoffers or who knows what. But hell, what's more important than family? I bet Ben knows what I'm talking about.
Kill that sumbitch!
Some holes in them! Thank you.
bounty hunter! Kill that sumbitch! I'm in the swamp. Kill that sumbitch!
Had enough?
Kill Grease! Kill that goddamn bounty hunter!
Waste your bullets. Go ahead. Ain't bothered me none. Shoot, I dare you. You gonna need a cannon. What are you gonna do?
Keep shooting. I don't mind.
You
I knew those Dalton boys were out there somewhere, standing together against anyone who would threaten them. And that's when I saw it. A goddamn steamboat.
A steamboat? In a swamp?
Yeah, Steve, but this wasn't much more than a wreck, really.
But how'd a damn steamboat end up in the swamps?
Guess it floated off during the flood of 89.
Now, was it a sternwheeler or a sidewheeler?
What? Does that really make a difference, Steve? It was a steamboat with a goddamn army on board. It was then that a fusillade of bullets come raining down from on high. And those vigilantes who accompanied me weren't anywhere to be found. But among those men that were shooting at me, I thought I saw some familiar faces.
Him in the process. Just kill him, for Christ's sake!
Somewhere up there, the Daltons were waiting on me.
You bastard!
Sounds like you don't give up too easy.
That's the kind of man I am, Ben. I set out to do something, I do it. Surrender just ain't in my nature. Plus, I'm stubborn as hell. Right about then, much to my relief, the vigilantes finally arrived. Their leader motioned at a cabin in the middle of the top deck, pointing me directly at the Daltons. I finally had them, after months of dogged pursuit. But it turned out that they had me.
Take them out! I'm sending you to hell!
The Daltons had played
not
me
so
like a fiddle.
All,
apparently, the vigilantes were on their damn payroll. They didn't just want to shoot me. They wanted to burn me alive. But finding my way out of a burning labyrinth proved to be quite a challenge.
It was a riverboat, right? I mean, it's not like it was a goddamn ocean liner.
Well, yeah, but I was in
Did
a fight.
Did you hear about that ship that's gonna launch next year? Largest one in the world.
You're talking about the Titanic. If you ask me, it's too blessed big. I don't think it'll even float.
So anyway...
Don't be stupid, Steve. They know what they're doing. They say that the Titanic is unsinkable.
Oh, God.
But getting back to that steamboat, how'd you get off it, Mr. Breeze?
I took in a lot of smoke that day, so I admit my recollection might be a bit hazy. But somehow, I managed to finally disembark. I was coughing up smoke and pretty damn pissed. I was done playing games with those boys. But finding my way out of a burning labyrinth proved to be quite a challenge.
It was a riverboat, right? I mean, it's not like it was a goddamn ocean liner.
Well, yeah, but I was
Did
in a fight.
Did you hear about that ship that's gonna launch next year? Largest one in the world.
You're talking about the Titanic. If you ask me, it's too blessed big. I don't think it'll even float.
So anyway...
Don't be stupid, Steve. They know what they're doing. They say that the Titanic is unsinkable.
Oh, God.
But getting back to that steamboat, how'd you get off it, Mr. Grease?
I took in a lot of smoke that day, so I admit my recollection might be a bit hazy. But somehow, I managed to finally disembark. I was coughing up smoke and pretty damn pissed. I was done playing games with those boys. It was time to settle this once and for all. Bob and Grat weren't about to come at me one at a time. They were in this together. Two brothers side by side, determined to take me down. Confident that this time the odds were on their side. They got it wrong. A sad end for those two. If they'd only known that Emmett was still alive despite his wounds. Paroled 14 years later, he moved to California and sold real estate and lived off the legend of that fateful day. And the tragic death of his two brothers. My own brothers died tragically as well, truth be told. It was 1868, and me and my older brothers were pulling a tidy profit running cattle into Juarez, Mexico. One night after my brothers retired for the evening, I found a little poker game in a cantina with a couple of cowboys. And I just couldn't lose. I even won an old Spanish coin that had to be 100 years old. Well, I was mighty pleased with myself the next morning as my brothers and I rode for Texas. But before we crossed the border, those cowboys caught up with us. It was Johnny Ringo, Roscoe Bob Bryant, and another asshole named Jim. They wanted their money back and everything else we had. Including our lives, as those boys didn't want us coming for them later. Bob put that old Spanish coin in my mouth and said, "I won't have it said that I left you with nothing, boy." Well, those horses bolted, and there we hung as those bastards rode away. The branch finally snapped under the weight of the three of us, but me and my older brothers were bigger and heavier. They were already dead. And right then, I swore to myself that I would avenge them. Ringo, you know about. But Bob eluded me until I heard he was riding with the Wild Bunch. I'd been on their trail for months, ever since they left their hideout in the Bighorn Mountains. Led by Butch Cassidy, they were a loose association of outlaws who robbed banks and trains from Colorado to Montana. Among them was the Sundance Kid, and that murderous hombre I was tracking, Roscoe Bob Bryant.
Are you a part of that giant Pinkerton posse after the Wild Bunch?
No, boy. A circus like that would have slowed me down. Besides, I wanted Bryant all to myself. I'd heard about a large shipment of gold being transported to Wilcox, Wyoming on the Overland Flyer. I figured the Wild Bunch would likely hit such a treasure, and by God, I figured right.